Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my weekly Minecraft stream. If you're wondering why the webcam's on this side instead of the other side like usual, it's because I've been playing some games recently where people have said that they felt the camera looked better on the right-hand side than the left, in particular Borderlands 3. And so I put it there, and I'm like, why keep moving it back and forth for every game? For now, we'll leave it over here. If we need to move it back for another game soon, I will. But for now, I guess it's fine being here. So yeah, it's my weekly Minecraft stream. We're going to chill out. We're going to have some fun. And I'm looking forward to it. Now, if you remember last week, we made a unique sculpture down there. There it is, the unique sculpture based on the top contributor. The top contributor last week, this week, never contacted me to tell me what they wanted me to make. Then on today's pre-stream, as I was starting up this stream on Twitch, they contributed again and said, I don't want you to build anything in my honor. Do whatever you feel like this week. Then they went ahead and gave me another $100 tip, as you can see up there, and basically said, you know, I'm happy that you're embracing memes like the Penne meme recently and stuff like that. But they haven't said for me to build anything. Apparently, they don't want me to. So I guess this week, I'm absolutely free to do whatever the hell I want in Minecraft without having to worry about naming something or building something, okay? So I guess that's cool. Every week up to now, you know, the past 2 months, I basically had to kind of, rush around to build something or get something done. And this week, it looks like we don't have to do that, okay? Now, what I'd like to do to start tonight... Oh, by the way, Philly Buckeye just did a 50-bit cheer and said, now this is pod racing. I think that's a meme of maybe a video game or something, but I don't know. Thank you, Philly Buckeye, for the cheer. So what I wanted to look at over here was, you know what? This really stupid sculpture of a cobblecock that we made last week. It's pretty silly. It's not terrible or anything, but it is pretty silly. Where'd my rainbow sheep go? Wait a minute. There he is. Okay, he's still in there. I wanted to make sure he was all right. It's pretty silly and stupid. I'm not gonna lie. So, but it is what it is. I think it's all right. I don't know if you guys think I should do anything to improve it. I basically did exactly to the specifications of that contributor who wanted me to basically put shrubbery around the bottom of it and everything. Philly Buckeye says, this cobblecock looks like a pod racer. So there you go. He says he thinks it looks like a pod racer. I mean, actually, you're right. It actually does look like a pod racer. You actually got a point. Oh, I did see The Phantom Menace, but is that a quote from the movie? I haven't seen Star Wars The Phantom Menace in a million years, so I wouldn't know if that's a quote from the movie or not. So, the cobblecock is complete, right? I don't think there's much else that I want to do with it for now. I guess we could just leave it as is. If you guys remember, originally, what we were doing before we got distracted by this thing is that I was going to build a building over in my village where I was going to basically make it like a farm for people. Whether it meant that I was going to use it to reproduce villagers, or I was going to try to make librarians or whatever. Like, that was what I was going to try to do. And I got monstrously distracted by this whole cobblecock fiasco. Okay? So if anything, I think what we should do is we should get our resources to get ready for a trip back to the village. Okay? And head back to the village and get back on our feet of what we were going to be doing. Since this week, I don't have any obligation. Nothing here that I really need. This week, I don't have any obligation to create anything for anyone. That's kind of a cool thing that I have freedom, right? So, let's go. An anonymous cheerer did 100-bit cheer. Thank you very much to the anonymous cheerer. Just a quick reminder, guys. If you are going to cheer tonight, please, if you can, use the Subway cheer mo. The only reason I say that is because you get 10% bonus bits to the streamer, and it costs you nothing. It's a great way to support any streamer, including me, so please consider it. I don't even remember this. DSP sounds shag off. I don't actually remember making that sign. That's how long ago it was. It was like so long ago. Will I ever play the Wild Arms games, as Burp Lover? It's possible. But they, I'll be honest, they look pretty bad. And they never remastered them, so they look really... The graphics are really, really bad in the Wild Arms games. So, people would have to accept that it's not going to be a graphically good-looking game or anything like that. Why do I have 26 arrows on me? Why do I... Yeah. Oh, hold on. There we go. I only need one arrow. I received another 100-bit anonymous cheer. Thank you very much. FBG Young Clout Boys Inc. tipped me a dollar and said, Choppa, eat a bitch, yo bitch. No, I'm not saying that's disgusting. That's absolutely disgusting. You're a revolting person. Thanks for the dollar tip. Okay. Okay. So, Twitch is paused to be $2.22 that we'd be playing more of the Call of Duty beta the next following weekend. Yes, in fact, next weekend, apparently they're launching Ground War, which is the giant scale map that they're going to be doing. I think it's supposed to be like a ridiculous amount of people in the map for Call of Duty, and I will be doing that next weekend. So the answer is yes. Thank you for the tip. Okay. So let's see. Do I have everything I need? I got my bed. I got the boats. I got some sticks and a shovel. I don't know why. I got a pickaxe. Jasper's in the hallway. I see him scratching his neck. You can hear him jingling. I got some wood. I don't know why. I don't need it. I guess I can put that away. Do I have any cobblestone that I could take with me? I don't think so. The signs I'll keep with me. The map I'm going to need for directions. I have one extra book for some reason. I don't see any cobblestone. I think I used all my cobblestone on the stupid cock. Oh, I have 62. I'll take it. Because remember, I needed the cobblestone to make the building for this farm device that I'm going to make. And, so I'm going to probably have to mine more cobblestone once I get there. Out of the cave that's there. What else? Whatever. What else is new? More mining, right? Even more. Okay, and I have sticks. I'm just going to need to make a few pickaxes. Hello, buddy. Hello. He's kneading the couch right next to me. Kay just cheered and said, shout out to Ash Ketchum for winning the Pokemon League after 22 years. Yeah, I saw this on Twitter. Apparently, he won the Alola or Aloha or whatever, the Alola region, which is Pokemon Sun and Moon. In the cartoon or the anime, he just won. He's the champion of that region. It's the first time he's ever been the champion of a region of Pokemon. Right, Bunny? It's the first time ever? It's the first time ever, right? So, after 22 years of perpetually being 10 years old, Ash Ketchum was finally a Pokemon champion. Congratulations to him. Philly Buckeye just cheered and said, why do you... hold on. He said, would you slaughter a bunch of younglings at the Genpei Tettle to save... At the Genpei... Let's try this again. Would you slaughter a bunch of younglings at the Jedi Temple to save Kat from dying? That's a tough question. Would I slaughter other people's children in order to save my wife? I don't like being put into situations and tough questions like that. I love my wife more than any other person on this planet, including myself. So I'd probably do pretty much anything I could in my power to save her life, but I don't know if I would want to take innocent lives to save a life. I don't know. Jackal McGocklin tipped me a dollar and says, why do you say people are sensitive over racist jokes that you get upset when people joke about your gout? Because racist jokes are silly if you do them in a general fashion. And what I mean by that is you can say, what's he playing with my wire? He's playing with a wire here. When you make a joke that's a racial generalization about a race, you know, say something about the Italian race or the Chinese or, you know, something like that, okay? It's usually meant to be a generalization. You're not directing that towards one person. It's not meant necessarily to be malicious. It's meant more to be like observational comedy of something in general to make a joke. Now, admittedly, people can get angry and get insulted or get touchy about it. And you have to be careful because some people just don't have thick skin and they don't like to have their culture insulted or dragged through the mud or even joked about. So everyone's different, okay? It's a subjective thing. For me, I could care less. You can say whatever you want about my culture. Everyone knows I'm a quarter Polish, I'm a quarter Italian, and people joke about it all the time. And I don't really give a shit what people say about it, okay? But some people are sensitive. Now, when you bring up a medical condition that I have, that is something that is hereditary. I can't help that I have it. I had to significantly change my lifestyle, and now I can't eat things that I used to like to eat. I can't do things that I used to like to do because I have a medical condition that could make my joints swell up and cause me excruciating pain, and it's not my fault. That's kind of fucked up. Okay, you take a jab at a heritage or whatever, you know, big deal. Take a jab at a medical condition that I'm suffering from that causes significant pain and suffering and is really a pain in my ass, you know, and you're doing it to use it as a way it means to insult. That's fucked up. All the time, people make fun of people with disabilities. That's fucked up. A sickness, a disability, things like that, that's ridiculous. Just like if you're going to insult someone personally because of their race, that's different than making a general joke about race, in my opinion, okay? Now, this is all me. You could completely disagree. That's fine if you do. But I'm just saying, you know, you make a general joke about race, I think that's okay. I'm not going to take offense. Versus if you personally go out of your way to insult me and say something about me that I can't help, like I have an illness, right? Some people make fun of me because of my post-nasal drip that I can't help. I've been to doctors for it over my life, and there's nothing you could do to treat it. It's just messed up that it exists. And I have to sometimes snort or clear my throat or do weird things that other people don't have to do because I have post-nasal drip. Is it funny to make fun of that? No, it's mean. It's demeaning because I don't want to have it. It's not something I enjoy having. I didn't choose to fucking have it. And now I got to suffer with it for the rest of my life, but you're going to make fun of me for it, right? It's fucked up. It's little petty shit from immature people. You know? Jasper is stepping on my keyboard right now. So if he accidentally sets something off, guys, I apologize. He's stomping right on the keyboard. Get your foot off there, buddy. Before you jump scare everyone again. He's so silly. I have my charging cord for my phone. I usually have it here on the love seat next to me plugged into my phone. But when it's unplugged, it's like a loose cord. Oh, he just stepped on something. Did you guys see that? He stepped on something. I don't know what he stepped on. It created something in OBS. It created an object in OBS, then it went away. I don't know what button he pressed. But he's trying to get the cord here that's like stuck in the cushion. So he's trying to get like leverage and stuff. And he's touching the keyboard and it's doing weird stuff. That's funny. Okay. So anyway, that's the deal. Timbo Slice Tree said, I just seen your tweet regarding the Sega Mini. I looked at my order and the same thing, which I ordered the same day it was announced. Seems like Amazon is not doing day one shipping on any of them. Oh, really? Seriously, Timbo? I didn't know that. Wow, that sucks. So no one's getting it on day one if they ordered it on Amazon? That's shitty. That's actually really shitty. I didn't know that. I thought I was getting it because we ordered it late. Oh, wow. So Timbo just clarified that has nothing whatsoever to do with when it was ordered. It's Amazon itself. Okay. Maybe Amazon will change that. Maybe Amazon will update the date if they end up getting more in stock early. I don't know. But I was told I'm getting mine around the 23rd. So thank you for letting me know, Timbo. Thanks for the clarification. FBG Young Clout Boys tipped me another dollar and did a bunch of lyrics I'm not going to read. I made breakfast cheers. So would you consider playing Plants vs. Zombies Battle for Neighborville? I know you really like the past Garden Warfare games. It would be a cool, chill stream. Is it on console? Is it a console game? I didn't even know that there was a Plants vs. Zombies game on consoles coming out. If it's a mobile game, the answer is no. I'm not checking it out. But if it's on console, I'd be interested. You're right. I did like the Garden Warfare games quite a lot. Elotion God did a 100-bit cheer and said, hey, Phil, I love it when the homie Jasper's on stream. You're my favorite streamer on Twitch. You hear that? You hear that, homie? Jasper, my homie. Did you hear that? People love it when you're on stream, Jasper. All right. Oh, my goodness. Golden Colt says, Jasper's trying to slap me in the face with his tail like Godzilla. There you go. PKD tipped me a dollar. He says, gout is totally controllable and caused by personal dietary choices. Wrong. It's a hereditary disease that's determined by acid levels in the body. Some people just genetically have more acid in their body. And yes, you're right. Actually adjusting your diet to have less things that create acid in your body would prevent outbreaks of it or flare-ups of it. But I have it because of my genetics. I don't have it because I was eating 40 pounds of red meat a day. You know what I mean? When I found out I had it, I freaked out because I was like, why do I have this? You know, why would I have it? That typically, people who have gout actually are like either really fat or just have incredibly unhealthy lifestyles. You know, we're talking like they drink a ton. They eat red meat constantly, every day, without any control over their diet. You know, that's the kind of people who overweight, really unhealthy people are the kind of people who get it. My aunt who had it was overweight. So no surprise that, you know, she had it and she had flare-ups and stuff. So for someone like me, who's considered not, I mean, am I overweight? Yes, a little bit, but I'm not like, bro, giant, grossly obese. For someone like me to have it is odd. In fact, that's what the doctor said to me when I went to see the doctor. She's like, well, does it run in your family? At that point, I didn't even know that it did. And I said, I have no idea, not to my knowledge. She's like, it's very odd for someone like you to have this. So you're going to have to make adjustments right away. So Anyway, that's the deal, and you don't know what you're talking about. Falcon, resub for 7 months, says, enjoyed being a sub and looking forward to hopefully a great gaming season. Awesome. Thank you, Falcon, for the continued support. Sour Patchy just cheers. So would you legally change your name to Puffy McSprinkles for $15 million? I mean, if I legally changed my name to Puffy McSprinkles, and I just didn't tell anyone, you know what I mean? I don't think I would want to be called Puffy McSprinkles for the rest of my life, but if it meant financial security for the rest of my life, maybe I would. I'm pretty sure that, you know, $15 million would be good to last me for the rest of my life, and I, you know, being financially secure and having no stress because of that would be pretty cool. So if someone's offering, let me know. I made breakfast, cheered. And he says, yes, Plants vs. Zombies Battle for Neighborville is out on consoles for September 4th. I did not know. Jasper, you are being super silly tonight. Look at him. He's all over me. You're being a super silly kitty tonight. A super silly kitty. You're all over the couch tonight. How silly, man. Now he's sitting on my lap. This is ridiculous. Okay. Anyway, we have to play Minecraft, buddy. We have to play Minecraft. People tuned in for the Minecraft chill stream. And, you know, you're being very silly. I wonder if I missed sleeping. Hoot TV cheered and said, would you try an ASMR stream? No. So we got one. I think we had $3 in tips that came in that I want to update the leaderboard. Oh. This is 126. What the? Oh my God. 120. 126 is what it's supposed to be. Okay. Good Lord. M5NSX is today 200-bit cheer. That makes M5NSX the top cheer of the night. And he says, what's up, Phil? Have you noticed the weather beginning to change? Yes, big time. Oh, here in the Seattle area of Washington State, just in the last couple of weeks, the temperatures have dipped by about 15 degrees Fahrenheit. And it is now cloudy and rainy, which is good. I like it. It's cool. It's very relaxing here in the office. I have the window open, the door open. The office feels great. You know, I don't feel stuffy. I don't feel, you know, hot at all. Even when, you know, one afternoon the sun was out, but I just had the fan blowing. It was good. Some people hate this, though. Some people actually hate it when this happens. And they actually say that in reality, they wish that it was sunny all the time. I'm the opposite. I came from the East Coast where we had hot, humid summers and all that stuff. I don't like it when it's hot. I like it when it's moderate weather. Because we didn't have a lot of moderate weather on the East Coast. It was always like an extreme of one way or another. So, I like this weather right now. There we go. So, thank you, M5NSX, for the top cheer of the night. Okay. Oh, good Lord. All right, well. That was a lot of stuff to get through. Thank you guys for your contributions. Shall we get started now? Shall we actually get started heading out towards the village? Let me make sure, again, there's nothing I'm missing. Everything that I needed to build the library was over there, except the cobblestone that I had to take back to make the sculpture last week. So everything else is in place. Okay. Supercrest, we just started, I'd say, about 15 minutes ago, maybe a little more. I know I started late tonight. Well, I've basically been talking with people for the past 15 minutes straight, so you missed nothing. We're going to head back to the village right now. Okay. Are you going to hang out with me tonight, buddy? Are you just going to chill on the couch with me? I think he is. He just has the little cord, my little lightning cable is poking up at the out of the crease in my love seat, and he's just going like this with his little paws. He's going, boop, 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 boop. He's playing with it. Boop, 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 boop. You can play with that if you want. Just don't bite it, okay? Just don't bite the cable. Play with the cable, okay. Bite, no. Okay. Omnipotent Froggins just cheered. 50 bits says, you seemed down in the dumpster in the pre-stream. As soon as Jasper entered the room, you really lightened up. Jasper must have been such a positive influence on you and Kat during these tough times. He really is. You guys seriously have no idea. Like, I told you guys, like, I was in serious jeopardy of losing my house in the last year. I thought I was going to have to leave here and move out and lose the place that I worked my ass off my whole life to earn. And I thought that Kat and I were going to have to go get some kind of a small shitty apartment where my stream quality was going to dip and be terrible and not have good internet. And I basically thought that, like, we were just starting our life together and that things were going to fall apart. And having him here, some days just him kind of playing around and messing around and being a sweet cat made us feel so much better. You know, especially with all the stuff going on behind the scenes with taxes and everything in the last year that really screwed with me in my head. And it helped out a ton. It really did. So. Okay. Let's see. It's Drake tipped me a dollar and said, I've been banned in chat for a while. Made me realize I've learned from my mistakes. With this dollar, I hope to regain your trust and be reinstated into the Frog Empire. It's too bad that's not how it works. If you want to be unbanned, you have to email me at darksidephil@hotmail.com with your name from the chat. I will look up the logs, see exactly what happened, the circumstances under which you were banned to begin with, to determine whether or not you weren't unbanned, and I will decide by myself if you should come back or not. Tipping has zero impact on it, okay? But thank you for the tip. All right. Burp Lover, I'm pretty sure that I have no opinion about a whaling ship that sank in the 1800s. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Okay, then. Alright, so let's be real, everyone. What are the chances that someone's going to beat Stinky Penne Penis for that $100 tip? Who is going to top that contribution tonight? Do we even have a chance? Is anyone actually thinking about doing that? Or are we just going to say, okay, we have a top contributor for the night? Does Jasper eat worms? Why would he eat worms? He's not an outdoor cat. He's never seen a worm in his life. Why would he be eating worms? Oh, my God. Okay. Keep going here. Polish Frog, yes, the $100 tip counts for the tonight's stream. That would be pretty messed up if it didn't. The stream was live, so it counted. I wasn't recording for YouTube at the time, but the stream was live, so it counts. Potage says that tip's too much for my blood. Bayless the God just tipped me a dollar. And is asking why I rage quit against Evil AJ. I didn't rage quit against Evil AJ. I played every match against him. You obviously don't even know what rage quitting means if you think I rage quit, you dumb fuck. So there you go. When is the next Indies Marathon? I don't know. You know, this month we're doing the Retrospective Marathon. Next month we're doing Halloween event. Maybe we'll do that as the goal for October. And we'll do an Indies Marathon in like November. Maybe. I don't know about you guys, but I want to date Colonel Sanders, right? Who wouldn't want to date Colonel Sanders? Let's go hit the ground here, and then we'll start heading west. But who the hell wouldn't want to date Colonel Sanders? Did I ever see Smokey and the Bandit? Nope, I did not. Never. Uh-oh, I think Jasper's had enough. He's leaving now. He's had enough of playing with this cord. He's had enough of playing with the cord. He's leaving. Oops. Oh, shit. There's a creeper right there. I wasn't paying attention. That's bad news, man. Thank you, M5NSX, for another cheers. And what if a group of us formed a conglomerate and each shipped $20? To top the 100, then voted by council on what to name. I mean, you guys could do that, but you got to do it all behind the scenes. Like, I don't want to be involved in it. You see what I'm saying? Like, you could very well go ahead and do that. I lost my boat. Oh, there it is. But one person needs to contribute so that their one contribution tops the current top contribution. So if you guys had all sent one guy their money via PayPal, and that guy tipped $101 to top the top tip, and then you guys wanted to vote on what you wanted to see, you could do that. Go right ahead. I can't stop you from doing that. But, you know, I'm not gonna have 10 people each send me $10, and then one person gives me $1 and say, okay, now collectively, we've topped the top contribution. That's not how it works. So, I mean, that would be ridiculous. Now I gotta start fucking tracking that stuff? Nah, no way, dude. That's asking for trouble. That's true, Polish Frog. He says there would be double the PayPal fees. I mean, you're right. If you pooled money together, everyone would be paying PayPal fees, I guess. So that is true. Do I massage Jasper with shoes? What? Do I massage my cat with shoes? No, I don't massage my cat with shoes. What the hell are you talking about? Ow! Is Planet Jeff banned? No. He was just here the other day, actually. He was just here the other day. Hilarious. He was laughing at the stupid garbage gossip that was coming out from the tractor saying that he had gotten banned or something. No. Planet Jeff actually is very rarely here. Every once in a while, he'll show up for a stream. And every once in a while, he's very generous on a stream. But he rarely watches live. Does Jasper like lasagna or hate Mondays? Both references to Garfield. I would not know if he likes lasagna because there's no chance in hell that I would ever give him pasta to eat. That's terrible. Why would you want your cat eating pasta? Completely unhealthy for a cat to eat pasta. So I wouldn't know in that regard. And there's my town, by the way, off of the distance. You can see it. He very well might hate Mondays. I don't know. I never asked him, actually. Non-binary keyboard tipped me $1 and says, I walked into a non-binary bathroom in church and saw the priest looking through a hole and the father on the other side. That's disgusting. I hope you reported this to your local authorities and that you had them come arrest this man immediately. That's incredibly disturbing. I mean, you got to report that stuff. You have to. I'm serious about that. You got to report that shit. You got me. He surprised me. He was he's kneading the side of the couch and he surprised me. You silly guy. Not M5 Venice X. I screwed up. Timbo Slice says that the Joker movie starring Joaquin Phoenix has been getting amazing reviews from movie festivals. Have you been following the movie and do you feel Joker should be as dark as this movie makes him? All I saw was the trailer for it, and of course whenever there's new pictures on Twitter, I see pictures and stuff. I mean, I think what the movie's trying to do is make Joker realistic. Because Joker is an incredibly over-the-top... How dare you? How dare you, buddy? The Joker is an incredibly over-the-top villain. Pretty unbelievable character in DC Comics. So, to make him realistic, they redesigned the character to have his own origin story that's very different from the one from the comics. And to say, if someone were to actually become a criminal called the Joker and act like that, you know, what would maybe cause it? How would it actually work in real life? That's essentially what they've tried to do. And it's incredibly freaky. And that's, maybe that's a good thing, right? I don't know. I can't comment. I haven't seen the movie. But the way I see it is this. Take a look at the Jared Leto Joker and the Joaquin Phoenix Joker. The Jared Leto Joker is literally, I have no idea what the Joker is or supposed to be, so let's just throw stupid ideas at a wall. Like, let's cover him in stupid tattoos that are incredibly dumb. You know, let's give him braces. Let's have him have these really weird mannerisms. You know, all these things that are dumb and have nothing to do with the Joker. So essentially what they've done, they ruin the character. Now, the Joaquin Phoenix Joker may be different, but at the core, they're trying to show you what if in real life someone became the Joker, this is how it would happen. That's an interesting take on it. Instead of being this ridiculous, stupid mishmash of cultural, you know, pop culture garbage like the Jared Leto Joker was, this one actually looks like some thought was fucking put into it. You're right, it's pronounced Joaquin. I keep saying Joaquin. It's Joaquin Phoenix. Joaquin. I always forget that, and I say Joaquin instead of Joaquin. I don't know why. I always forget how to say his name. Oh, I'm pretty sure I have to mine now. Let's see. Because I need a ton of cobblestone. I currently have about 100. I don't think that's going to be enough. Especially not for what Papa Vera had in mind. So, I think I'm going to have to do some mining of cobblestone to get more for this project. By the way, I'll put my boats away. Oh, you know what? I'm going to put them over here so I don't lose them. Okay, yeah, all I have are, there are hoes. I don't have any pickaxes. Here we go. I was wondering where this pickaxe... I thought I had more pickaxes. From when the last time that I mined this stuff. So I might not have to make any pickaxes. I might have enough. Okay. Well, I guess we're off to the cave over here to mine some cobblestone. M5NSX just cheered and said, any interest in the It Chapter 2 movie? Of course! I liked It Chapter 1. I thought it was pretty good. It wasn't, like, blow me away amazing. No, but I thought it was pretty good. So I want to see the sequel. I'm definitely not seeing it in theaters. I'll have to wait till it eventually is on demand somewhere to see it. Hopefully it'll be on like Netflix or something at some point. Just like Avengers Endgame, I doubt I'm ever going to see at this point. It's been an unseen movie for me for years. Okay. Money equals happiness. Subscribe to the channel. I don't necessarily agree with that, but thank you for the subscription. Baby Man Gaming Cheer said, hey, Phil, I know that you like me. No way, no way. Huh? What? Okay. Sure. I don't know what that means. M5NSX thinks that Chapter 2 is better than Chapter 1. It was a song reference? Well, I don't know the song, so that went right over my head, dude. Pog Milf BBC. What the fuck? Oh, my God. Timmy Adelson, when's the last time you saw a black person? I saw one at Whole Foods yesterday. Well, it would have been the last time that I was out, which was Friday. Because Saturday and Sunday, I was home. So, it was just me and Kat, and we're white. So, I didn't see a black person. Unless you're talking about, like, on TV... Then probably within the last couple days, definitely something that I watched, like WWE, right? It Chapter 2 is great, says Madara is God. That's good to hear. What does BBC mean? British Broadcasting Corporation. Everyone knows that. Mr. Papa Vera cheered. He says, you're going to need a lot of cobble. In fact, near where you're building, I would place some double chests to store materials you're using. I did also show you plans to make a crafting storage room, which should come in handy. Something to consider near your building. Or while you build. While you're mining for cobble, grab iron if you find it. It won't hurt to save more. Thank you for the recommendations, Mr. Papa Vera. All right. Alright. Keep going. This is very exciting, by the way. If you can't tell, I'm riveted doing this. But please, by all means, let's keep talking to keep me occupied, guys. Before I fall asleep. Is my gated community diverse? I would say so. I know there are some African Americans who live here. Asians, white people, Hispanics, I'm trying to think if I can think of anything else right now. By the way, we're up to $128 in tips. I'm trying to think. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. I think that's it. What's the point of the gated community? To keep crime out? It's not a public street. If you even walk on this street without permission, you're breaking the law. So it basically makes it so that anyone can't just walk on here and do whatever they want. They can't go in your yard. They can't steal your shit. You know what I mean? It keeps the crime out. And we've had almost zero crime since I've lived here. Almost. So. Native American? That's a good question. I don't think we have any Native American people living here in our community. I could be wrong, but I don't think we do. No, I do not have a big bro. Spawn killer should be $2. So what are you doing today in Minecraft? I am late. Well, essentially what we're doing is we're going to try to get going on our building that's going to be kind of a farming facility for people. Whether that means we reproduce villagers, we have librarians. Later on, maybe we use it for monster farming and experience farming. Whatever it may be, Mr. Papa Bear gave me kind of the blueprint layout to do it. And I want to work on that today, but we need a lot of resources. So I was told to mine a ton of cobblestone, and that's what I'm doing right now. Okay. Since I'm not having kids, does that mean the Burnell name ends with me? I mean, no. My dad has other family members. Oh, my nose itches. My dad has other family members that will probably continue on the legacy. I don't know them, or I'm not really friendly with them. So in that regard, maybe, I don't know. No! My pickaxe! Any progress on getting grass in my backyard? Absolutely not, Dacky Smurf. Maybe someday, but that's something that would cost a lot of money. We'd have to have people come with, like, a jackhammer and tear up all the concrete so that then we could, like, basically till the soil and make it tenable to grow stuff in again. So that's a lot of money to have that done. I don't have money for anything, so certainly if I don't have money to pay my bills, I don't have money to take my wife out and do something nice for her birthday, I don't have money to do that shit. So, Falcon 32395 did a 201-bit cheer. So, how's Jasper doing? And cheer war anyone? Laughing out loud. So, Falcon's the top cheer of the night. Jasper was in here for a good 20 minutes earlier, going crazy, walking across my lap. He was playing with the cord over here. So, he's doing well. I don't know where he went. More than likely, he went off to either look out a window, because I have all the windows in the house open so he can look out at night. Or he's probably off to go have a nap or something. So, thank you for the cheer, Falcon. I appreciate that. Mr. Papa Vera cheered again. He said, I don't think that was cobble you were mining. Cobble, cobble, cobble. Andesite, cobble. Cobble, cobble. You're right. I picked up a little bit of andesite. Oh. Oh, my God. Excuse me. Oh. Indigestion. Shout out to M5NSX, who tipped me $2. He says, I'm glad you embraced Minecraft. It's always a fun, interactive stream. I mean, yeah. And this is a game that, at one point, I was so ignorant and stupid when I was, you know, 10 years younger that I thought that anyone who played Minecraft was a mindless kid. And I thought the game was really pointless and had no value. And that's because I was an ignorant idiot who refused to try new stuff and couldn't possibly believe that something that maybe I didn't have any kind of interest in could possibly be worth playing because I was an ignorant idiot. Thank God in the last 10 years I've changed. I mean that too. Like, I used to talk out of my ass so much about stupid shit and insult people and just say dumb shit because I felt that it would get a rise or, you know, I wouldn't even know what I was talking about. I'd be like, fuck it, I don't care. I can say and do whatever I want on the internet because I have a YouTube following. And I didn't realize that that kind of stuff hurts people, you know? That it could be harmful to certain people. That, you know, people believe what I say and I have a following of people. And I have a responsibility that when I say and do stuff that I'm responsible with what I say and do. Because some people take everything I say as fact, you know. But I wasn't in that mindset back then. Back then I thought, oh, YouTube's a joke. YouTube's just a silly, frivolous thing that I do on the side, and it should never be taken seriously or anything like that. So I don't care what I say and do, and I take no responsibility for anything. You know what I mean? Here we are 10 years later, and Minecraft is the longest-running chill stream I've ever done. I've been doing this since December. It's now September. So you're talking, you know, almost 9 full months I've been playing the game. Who on earth would have thought that that would have ever happened, right? Oh my god. Someone just tipped a dollar making jokes about Breitbart, which is a really right-wing website. I know because I see people talking about it in my social media feeds of politics. So I understand you're making a joke about it, but I'm not going to talk about that because I don't want to talk about politics at all. So, sorry, I appreciate the dollar tip. I understand it's just a joke. I don't take offense at all. But, you know, politics ain't a thing that I do on my streams, okay? So, hopefully you understand that's why I'm not going to address that. Okay. I'm just going to get right back to work mining. Ha-la-la-la. Okay. Sleepy Reader says, little did Phil know he's on the path to becoming a Minecraft-only streamer. That's right. All Minecraft, all the time. No variety in the stuff that I do whatsoever. Okay. Ever try to show my sauce on burgers? Hell no. I don't think I've ever had like a marinara or a pasta sauce on a burger. No. Let me think about this. I've had a chili cheeseburger before. So I've had chili on a burger, but I've never had pasta sauce on a burger. I've had like Italian marinara sauce on chicken because you have like a chicken parm sandwich, like a chicken breast, a breaded chicken breast with some melted cheese and like red sauce on a sandwich bun. I've had that before. So the surprise is wondering if my wife is a Minecraft fan. I don't know if she's a Minecraft fan. Sometimes I tell her about the stuff that I do in Minecraft. And she has a good laugh at if something funny happened or whatever. I told her about how there's 100 cats in this town and they're very cute. And she thinks that's awesome. Because obviously she's a cat lover. But I don't know if she's ever played Minecraft herself, quite frankly. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. What is my favorite reptile? I don't have a favorite reptile, I don't think. Did I ever ditch from school before? The only time I ever ditched from school was in college. Because at that point in my life, I had a car. So if I didn't feel like going, I just wouldn't go. And it happened probably for like 2 different classes that I absolutely fucking hated and I skipped a lot. But no, I never had the opportunity to skip out a class for like high school or nothing because I always was driven to school by my parents. It wasn't like there was any opportunity for me not to go. I was already fucking there, you know? Okay. I'm gonna keep going. I'm gonna get a lot more if I can. What is my favorite soda? I would say for a refreshing cola drink, probably Pepsi. I like Coke with like dinners, but if I'm just gonna have soda to drink, I probably prefer Pepsi. I think overall my favorite, I like Dr. Pepper a lot. I think Dr. Pepper is really good. It's a very unique flavor. different from cola. So I'm probably Dr. Pepper. How many girls did I pick up in my car when I got one? Oh, what I would do, I would just drive all the girls from town around. I would just keep offering free rides, and they would just stack up, like a stack of pancakes in the back seat. They'd go on top of each other. So I'd fit a good 70, 80 girls a day in my car, all stacked in there, driving them all around town. It was great. Very exciting. What do I think about ES6? If you mean Elder Scrolls 6, I have no thought on Elder Scrolls 6. We haven't heard anything about it. We don't know any information about Elder Scrolls 6 at all, besides it's in development. So it would be impossible for me to formulate any kind of an opinion on something we don't know anything about. Spawn Killer sent me another $2 and says, did you hear that the lead singer of the Cars died today? I did. I saw that on Twitter, and that's unfortunate. Eddie Money passed away the other day, too. A lot of rock singers passing away this week. That's sad. I guess the Cars is more of a... Would they be considered a rock band or a pop band? I don't even know. I guess they're kind of both. Polish Frog says, are kids out of the question because of my financial situation, or... is it something you wouldn't want to do regardless? I would say both. Like, number one, all right. Number one, there's absolutely no way I could have kids. I can't afford it. I wouldn't be able to raise a kid. And without basically trying to qualify for a ridiculous amount of, like, government assistance and stuff, there's no way I could ever raise a kid. And with the amount of money that I make, despite the fact that I have a ton of debt in my name and it's not disposable income, but the amount of money that I make, I wouldn't qualify for any government programs to raise a kid. Okay? So it's kind of out of the question regardless what I think. Now, as for my personal feelings, I feel that if I was going to be a father, I would have been much earlier in my life, maybe like, you know, anywhere between 5 to 10 years ago. That would have been the perfect time for it. I don't know how, even though people still pull this off, I don't know how I could be like 60, 70 years old and be having a kid. You know what I'm saying? Like, right now I'm 37. If I were to have a kid today, in 20 years, when he's 20 and just starting off on their own, I'd be, you know, hitting 60, retirement age, right? When that kid is off, ready to start a family, I'd be about to die, you know? So, I think it'd be like, I kind of missed the boat on that. I would have had to be younger, even though I agree with you guys that actually a lot of people are having kids much later in their lives now. That's kind of a thing, a running trend in the United States in particular. I think I kind of missed the boat. And quite frankly, and this is just me being very honest, I don't ever, never really had a time in my life where I had like a big desire to have kids. Some people do. Some people, they have this like, man, I can't wait. One day I want to have my kid of my own and I want to raise them to be a, you know, have a family and they can pass on my legacy and all that. I never really had that desire ever in my life. Never. I'm not saying it's a bad thing to have. I said for whatever reason, it just never happened to me. I never felt, man, I want to be a father and so have someone that I can raise or whatever. Now, maybe I hate to say, I don't want to hate to say this, but maybe to some extent that has to do with the fact that I have an internet presence. So bear with me for a minute here. Maybe because every day I get to talk with you guys publicly and share my opinions and let you know about stuff in my life and give you life experience stories and try to give you guys good advice based on mistakes and things that I've made in my life. Maybe I kind of feel somewhere in the back of my head that like I have helped people and passed on the knowledge that I have through my daily streams and through these videos that are immortalized forever on the internet. And because of that, maybe I don't worry about, man, I need to have a kid so I can pass all that knowledge on, because I already have, okay? Maybe I'm completely off base here, right? But maybe there's some people out there who they don't have a following like me. They don't have an internet presence. So they feel like the only way they're ever going to be remembered, or the only way that they're ever going to be have anything that they've learned in their life pass on to be a useful experience for someone else is if they have a kid to pass it on to, right? I'm not in that situation whatsoever. So, and no, I'm not calling you my kids. What I'm saying is you are the people who on a daily basis I interact with and pass my knowledge on to. So I kind of have that thing already. Where it feels, it's not like, I don't feel like my life is being wasted. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't feel like my life is going to waste or that things that I've learned are not going to be used because I kind of share that stuff with you guys. It's amazing to say that because a lot of people don't have that. A lot of people go their whole lives without anyone to really talk to or share stuff with, and that's really sad. But that's not my situation. I'm very lucky, very, very lucky to have what I have on the internet. Okay, I know that. By the way, I think I might have enough cobblestone. I think this might be enough. I could be wrong. M5NSX, cheers. Can you sing Nickelback? Yes, but I'm not going to. Big Papa Phil tipped the dollar, says, what's your strongest creative talent, like creative writing, drawing, painting, building things, etc.? I have absolutely no idea. I really have no idea. Is it on-the-flight commentary? Is it the ability to captivate and entertain? I don't know what the fuck it is. I'm not an expert on this stuff, okay? But thank you for the dollar tip. The Thrilla just subscribed to the channel for 2 months in a row. Thank you to The Thrilla for the support. Okay. Oh my god. So goes the prize says, hypothetically speaking, if you had a son, he loves video games, and one day you decide to introduce Super Turbo to him, and he says, Dad, this game sucks ass. Street Fighter V is way better. How would you react? I would dump him in a trash can, head first. And I say, get all that garbage out of your system, son. Go ahead and spew it right into that can, and when you're ready, when you feel like you got it... When you feel like you got it all done, I'll pull you back out of that can. Captain K-Man at 100-bit cheers, says somebody ring the Dinkster. What? What the hell does that mean? Somebody ring the Dinkster. What? Excuse me? What does that mean? Okay. Well, I almost broke my legs. So I think what I should do, I should take Papa Vera's advice, and I should like move a lot of the items that I'm gonna need for building into a storage area right next to it, like make me a shed or just a couple chests to have storage next to it, and that's a good idea. So what I need to do is make a couple chests. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Fuck! Okay. 4 chests. Now, what do I need to build a library? Well, let's see here. What do I need? I'm not going to need the wood anymore. For now, I don't need the signs. I'll put those away. Okay. I don't need the wood. That looks fine. I'll probably bring more torches. You could always use more torches. Okay. A random enchanted book. Where did I put all my ingredients? Remember I had paper? And I had paper and to make books out of. And then I used the books to make the lecterns. Where the hell did I put the lecterns? Where are they? Wait a minute, where the hell are they? I don't see the lecterns anywhere. I know I brought them here. What the fuck? Right? They're not here. Am I blind? I know I brought the lecterns. Oh, there they are. Okay, so I need the lecterns. I don't know what else I'm gonna need. All right, I need to see if I can bring up this blueprint from Papa Vero from weeks ago. I favorited it, so hopefully I should be able to find it. Let's see. Let's see, how do you do this? Okay. Okay, almost there. Where is it? Where is it? Here it is. Ha ha. Looks like he alternated with a different kind of stone when he built this thing. Okay. I seem bored. I'm not bored at all. I have fun talking to you guys, and I'm looking up the blueprint to figure out how I'm going to do this. It looks like it's pretty long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 20. 27 blocks long and 6 blocks wide. So I need a 27 by 6 area to do this. Oh boy. Okay. Here's what I'm very serious. So the different colors are only there to help you count. Thank you. Yeah, I see. 27 by 6. So where was I going to do this? Oh, by the way, Freddie B just cheered. So when are you playing Gears Horde mode? That's my favorite thing about Gears. Tomorrow night. I'm going to try it out tomorrow night on standard difficulty this time. And I'm hoping that we get variety. By the way, hopefully I can use my ultimate this time. Remember I picked JD and I didn't know how to activate his ultimate at all. So I just sat there with the ultimate the whole time not knowing what the fuck I was doing. So hopefully that doesn't happen this time around. All right, so do I have another shovel? I don't think I do. I might have to make another shovel because I have to do some digging to clear some land away to make a 27 by 6 square foot area. Here's about versus. Can I see the full size images? I don't know, dude. Right now I'm on Twitter. I'm not on your blog. I don't even know if I could see your blog fully on my phone. Prime Rib, my gear stream went well. I finished up the Gears 5 campaign today, which was fun. So it did go well. Thanks for asking. Oh, I was looking for a shovel. Nope, I don't have one. Stone shovel? If I use iron, I can make an iron shovel. There you go. Meow. Meow. Now, where was I going to put it? At the other entrance, right? Wasn't it the front entrance I was going to do this? Thought it was this way. Yeah. Yes, let's see over here if I can do it over here. Ah! Mr. Bubba Vera. Ah! I'm stuck. Mr. Bubba Vera says, he cheers. The forums I recommend, it was slightly updated. You can click to see the full-size images. Inside the images are also text to explain some parts. Okay. So, can we count 27 blocks? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12... 60, 70, 90, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm fairly confident we can fit it here right before the fall off into the water. I think we can fit it here. The catch is I have to make it perfectly flat. The width of 6 is easy. This path alone, the width is 3. So basically just go 4, 5, 6. So start here. clear all this out here. Stupid thing, I keep making pop, pulling dirt out of the holes by accident. I'm trying to do that. Okay. Did I save JD or Dell? I saved Dell. Because I figured if this would be realistic, that she would save Dell, who's been with her the whole journey. JD, she just had a falling out with, and, you know, yeah, he just came back and was nice, and they kind of, you know, trust each other again. But I would figure she would have saved JD over Dell. No, excuse me, she would have saved Dell over JD. I said that completely opposite. Yeah, she would have saved Dell over JD. Jasper tipped me $1 and I'm in the kitchen, can't find the catnip. Well, that's good, because you shouldn't have access to catnip willy-nilly. It should only be when Cat and I decide that you have it. You shouldn't just be eating catnip out of nowhere. That's not good. That would not be good. Cat on the loose on catnip. Is this a dead end, or is it go deeper? Oh, fuck. Oh, shit! So I walked over, a fucking creepy spider came after me. Look at this fucker. Fuck you! If that's not a case for blocking it off, I don't know what is, right? Okay. Yes, I am aware that it takes an increasing amount of time to gain levels once you're higher level. I hear you. I don't care. Right now, I'm not caring about my levels at all. Looks like it's going to be nighttime. I got to go sleep. We'll come back and continue. Okay. So far, so good.